go get used to playing again.
I'd like to start at 17. Make sure that when we're playing through this part, we make sure that we're listening for all the different moving lines. We're missing an alto and two trumpets, but we will manage. So in this part, we want to be listening for the horn player and for the flute player, but since Catherine's already played this melody once, I want to color this horn. So really make sure you're listening for Sarah here. Okay. All right, starting at 17.
Thank you.
16th notes through the measure, and we have the bass clarinet and the bassoon and the tuba who have the last four 16th notes with her, so we need to make sure that that lines up properly. So one measure before 61. I liked the amount of crescendo that Alex had, so if we can match that all to the bassoon section there, a little bit more from the tuba. In place. Start right on 61 this time. Should be moving here at the same time until you get to the fourth measure of 93. So make sure that if you have something that is not the same as either of those three measures, that you bring that out. If you have the whole note there, back it off just a little bit so we can hear everybody else. Right on 93. From the amount of change we're going to make, and make sure clarinet one, that in the third measure you really bring out that beat two. You're the only one in the whole band that has that. Starting right at 106.
So if you just free up your arms a little bit, I think you'll be more comfortable.
Okay.
Chris. You have a wonderful outlook when it comes to trying to shape the sound the way you want it to, and using the flow of your body to be able to get the desired sound. The thing is, your hands are literally together at the exact same moment. So right here is a moment of contact, and here's your baton. So now there's...
Yeah.
So I liked your face of, you liked when I played it correctly,
mm-hmm.
and you were living in that time zone, so that was nice. And also, I wanted to make the comment that your shade at Darby not being here was on high today. I mean, it's like four or five times.
The
well,
alto has
not
like
here.
Four moving lines by themselves. Chris?
got a lot done, like, in the short amount of time that you were up there. So I think that was really, like, good rehearsal management.
I want to make just a general comment about the idea of energy. Sometimes, like I've noticed, a lot of motion, you were referring to that a while ago, with like with the legs moving to and fro, the basic concept there is give them one thing to focus on, not two or three. But the general comment of energy that I found very intriguing, that I learned when I was studying conducting at the conservatory in Cincinnati, is that energy is just energy. A lot of us, when we're growing up, we're trained to think of energy as we get nervous, and then the body reacts. But I'd like to advise you to think about energy in a different way, that it's just fuel that you can use as your ally. So it's good to have the energy, and we have to change the mindset as to how we frame it for ourselves. That's energy. All the great conductors have it. Bernstein had it. Von Karajan had it. They want it. They use it. We think of it as, well, I'm getting nervous and I start moving around, but they channel that energy into what music makes. So that's just a general concept that applies to all of us. It's worth thinking about it. Good job.